Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about header and footer. Now sometimes it may be needed that some text or images to appear on every page of your document. Like this document, you can see Microsoft Word, this text with the image or logo of Microsoft Word appear on every page of my document. As well as you can see that page, all the pages of this document are numbered. So how can you achieve this? Thus options header and footer serve this purpose. So to demonstrate that, I am going to open another new document. So I am going to open a blank document here. Now in this blank document, let's copy some text from the first document to this. All the headers and footers also appear. So now let's open another blank document, and this time I am going to create some dummy text by myself. So I am creating some dummy text here, and you can see there are total 3 pages. Now I am going to add a text that would appear on every page of the document. Now as the name, the header appears on the top of each page and footer appears on the bottom of each page. Both these would appear outside the margin area. So to add header, firstly go to the insert tab, and inside this header and footer group you can see the header, footer and page number option. Now first I am going to add the header. When you click on the header button, you can see a lot of varieties or a lot of preset options here. You can select anything from here according to your need, but right now I am going to use the blank, that is the custom one. So when I'm clicking on this blank, you can see a placeholder saying type text appear here. Also a design tab under header and footer tools appear on the ribbon. So first of all, I'm going to some text. Now the text that appears in the header and footer area can be formatted just like any text in your main document. So if you want, you can use this mini toolbar to change the styles, change the font size, etc., etc. You can also change its alignment, and you can see there are some tabs, the center tab and the right tab. So I am pressing the tab, so it appears at the center. You can underline it, you can color, do it according to your need. Now if I want to add some pictures here, I'm clicking on this area. You can see there are some more options from this insert group. That is, you can add date and time. You can add some quick parts. You can add picture. You can add clip art. Anything you want. I am going to go for the picture option. And from, I am going to select this word icon and click on insert. Now this picture is very, very large. So I'm going to resize it according to my need. And the picture is resized and appears on the page. So I'm not closing now header and footer. You can see it appears on every page of my document, and it says header here. As you scroll down, you can see a area for the footer also appears by default. It also appears by default when you add header. Similarly, when you're going to add footer, area for the header also appears automatically. So now I am going to the design tab, and you can see a portion, a option here, go to footer. So I am going to click on this go to footer, and the cursor automatically appears in the footer section. Now for the footer section, I am going to add some page number. So inside the design tab, in the header and footer group, you can see the page number option. Now as it is the bottom section of your page, I am going to add the bottom of the page option, and you can see plenty of page number, adding options. You can select anything from here. I am adding a very simple one though, just like this. So it is the third page, so it appears three. Now as header, you can also format this area. You can change the color or font style of your page number. You can change this, you can change this color of these designs, the lines which appear with the page number. So you can go to the format tab under drawing tools and you can change the color of this line. You can change the background of your page number also. Do whatever you want using the format tab. So in this way you can add some header and footer, and after your work is done, go to the design tab once again and you can see there is an option, close header and footer option. So when this header and footer option is active, you can say the main content of your document appears gray in color and it becomes inactive. So when you click on close header and footer, you can see your main content of the documents becomes active again and your header and footer section goes inactive, but it remains there. You can see it. So when you're going to click on the print preview option, you can see both your headers, main content and the footer are prominent. So I'm going to close this print preview. Now in this way you can add any text or any image that you want to appear on every page of your document using headers and footers option. That's all for this video.